Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. It's an absolutely amazing feeling being here inside the Rawdah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If you see here, there's a hadith in which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam authentically, it's been reported that he said that whatever is between my grave, or my house rather, which is now his grave, and his minbar, which is this, is a garden from the gardens of Jannah, subhanAllah. Now, just a few things to point out, some amazing things. Firstly, the pillars, they have some markings on them. They're called ustawana, meaning a pillar, and that is the ustawana of sarir, which means the pillar of relaxing, of sleeping. And they said that the Prophet ﷺ used to set up his tent for i'tikaf just there. Over here now, the next pillar to its left, where you can see that man is sitting with a security guard, that, they said, is the pillar in which Ali radiallahu ta'ala sometimes would sit at, or the spot that he would sit at to watch over the house of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This pillar here, this one is supposed to be the pillar which Abu Lubaba, a companion of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he tied himself to this pillar because he made a mistake and he regretted it so much that he said, I'm going to tie myself here and I'm not going to release myself until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives me. And Allah jalla wa ala did forgive him, I believe, after 4 nights of tawbah. However, the most special minbar, the most special pillar rather, is this one here. This is called Ustuwan of Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha. And the story goes, there is a narration that says, in which the Prophet said that Aisha, if the people knew how much reward there is for praying here, then they would flock to it and they would draw lots to see who could pray here. So this is actually the best spot to pray in the Rawdah, right here behind this pillar. And then to the right of that, you have the mihrab of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. People always try to fight to pray there, but the way that the mihrab has been constructed after him is so thick that in fact, if you did sajda even inside it, you wouldn't be touching the place of the head of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Rather, you'd be probably where his feet were. However, that little pillar behind it, that goes up there, behind the minbar of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that is actually known as the pillar of Hannana, which means crying. And the story goes that that pillar is where a tree used to be, which the Prophet used to lean against to deliver his khutbah. And then when they built the minbar of the Prophet further away from that, and the tree was left, the tree began to cry, and the crying sound of it is known as Hannana. And so that pillar behind the mihrab, it represents that. There's so many, subhanAllah, amazing things that took place there, and the feeling that you get is unbelievable, because you may be standing, subhanAllah, where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, or where Abu Bakr, or where Umar, or where any of the great companions radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'een stood and prayed. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala unite us with our Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in Jannatul Firdaws al-A'la. Allah.